How many of you guys enjoy living with roommates?
I've never lived with a roommate.
You've never lived with a roommate?
Only boyfriends. Does that count?
Yeah, yeah. I guess so. Yeah.
I don't feel like it counts because I can still control everything.
Yep.
Oh, you can control your boyfriend, right?
Well, I mean, not him, but I get to,
do you
like,
feel
I get
like you're
to
being
pick
controlled
the decoration.
By her?
Why do you know that, though? I don't like that you know that.
No, I meant, like, I get to control the decorations and, like, the, because that's all I didn't want roommates for. I didn't want to fight over decorations or who gets to use a TV or whatever. It's like,
yeah, yeah.
I'm using the TV, okay?
Fair.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
It's a give and take.
TV.
Give and take?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what's your take?
I didn't realize that people just have different standards.
No. It's infuriating, too, when you realize that. And there's nothing you could do about it with roommates.
Dude, I had a roommate and his hair was going great, and so he would use Just for Men all the time. By the time he moved out, we had to like get all everything fucking replaced because the sinks were all fucked. Like they were like permanently dyed, like the same color that his hair dye was, and all the shower sinks were the same way.
He just didn't clean it after?
Fuck no, he didn't.
Damn.
Yeah.
But it helps in a lot of ways too if you don't have any family or whatever and you don't want to bother people that much, because it's kind of like a community where you can, by sharing, you can get more things. Like when I had roommates, like there's no way I couldn't afford a 5-bedroom home on my own.
Right.
But I get to access a 5-bedroom home and there's always company.
Yeah.
So you never feel like there's like you're bored or nothing. There's always something happening, right? And it's always cool. Like you have people to talk. It's like a family, right? And then, yeah. And then when you gotta get out of town, like you feel that your house is safe.
Get out of town.
When you're out of town and you're just like, yeah, everything's safe. Everything's taken care of, whatever.
I still have roommates mentality, actually, I think.
With her?
Well, just no, in general, because I used to live with a roommate, and then, like, when you see something in the fridge, it's not yours, you don't eat it or drink it or whatever.
Oh, a normal person does it.
Right,
yeah.
Well, right.
Some crazy roommates will just eat all of it.
True,
yeah.
But I wasn't that guy. But when I open the fridge, even if it's full and it's only Nikki's stuff, I'm like, I have nothing to eat in here.
Damn, really?
And I told him to eat this. I bought double food so that we both eat it. Like
maybe he sees the raw cauliflower and he's like, that's not food.
Yeah, exactly.
That's not a hamburger.
It is, because when I make my food, guess who always wants it?
It's delicious.
Yeah.
So well, maybe the process of making.
If I make the servings, then I share, like he gets a serving, but
he won't just
take food and make it on his own.
You don't go into the fridge and be like, oh, there's a box of blueberries, and you just start munching on blueberries?
I don't.
Because that's what you'd do.
That's not like, out of respect, he just doesn't eat fruit. If it's a monster, yeah, he'll take it.
Let's clear the record here. You're right, I don't eat fruit. I do eat vegetables, though. All the time.
Which vegetable? Oh,
frozen vegetables.
Potatoes? Bell peppers.
Bell peppers, peas, carrots, those little green beans. I eat all that shit.
That
love it.
That sounds like canned vegetables.
He doesn't eat vegetables.
I do. Damn it, I'm gonna clear the record on this shit.
We're gonna bring in like a bowl of vegetables for you to eat one of these episodes, just to prove the point.
When I make my chicken dinner thing, I always add.
Is that a TV dinner? Sounds
thing.
Like a chicken TV dinner.
It doesn't sound edible with the word thing in there, dude.
Frozen chicken that I heat up on a skillet, and then I add frozen veggies to it. You know I do this.
When he sees a thing of blueberries, he goes, ew, something from the earth?
It hasn't been frozen yet. What is this?
Both of those things are from the fucking earth. They just got flash frozen.
Oh, shit.
Whatever.
Does it remind me of a bag of peas?
But yeah, the reason why I bring up the whole roommate thing, we have an article here where a mom is ready to throw out her teenage daughter after she found this in the microwave.
What the fuck is that?
Is that a cat? That's what she thought.
Is that a moldy fucking thing that she-
Ew, is it mold?
That's mold.
Oh, that's mold?
That's mold.
I thought that was fur.
How has no one used the microwave in that long?
Yeah.
She's an oven user.
The mom probably cooks.
So the mom apparently, cooks, or they just order out all the time, and there's no need to use a microwave for some reason.
Well, so they don't have leftovers, they need to warm up?
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Well, it's funny you say that, because this actually was a leftover.
Well, looks like they don't have leftovers.
Daughter got like some sort of noodle chicken dish, like sounds like Asian food, and she didn't finish it one day. So she stuck it in the microwave thinking that she'll eat it a couple hours later and she'll heat it up instead. It's just already in a spot that
6 months.
And no, check it. This is only a week.
What?
So I'm like, what the fuck was in your microwave?
I kind of do want to pet it though.
No.
It looks kind of soft.
You know, the craziest part is the mom was saying how this thing is so bad that it doesn't even stink anymore. Like, dude, she was saying, like, it's whatever is inside underneath that fur, it's trapped all the smells and stuff, because it didn't smell. It's just this fuzzy fucking mold thing.
You should leave it in every room and it'll collect all the fucking bad vibes and shit.
The cure for corona is in there.
Gotta be.
Someone needs to fucking investigate that thing.
That didn't smell? Yeah. That doesn't smell? Are you kidding me?
It looks smelly.
It got so disgusting that it clean started growing on it.
Yeah, like, that shit got cultures, man.
It like insulated all the smell into there.
It looks like it smells like wolf.
What does wolf smell like?
Smell. Oh, remember their settlement.
You got close enough to smell a wolf?
Yes.
We went to a wolf sanctuary.
We did. We pet a
wolf. But they're not full wolf. Though they're like maybe 70%.
Oh, that doesn't count.
And if they got
captured, hybrids.
If they got captured, they're not really wolves anymore.
Oh, they're not wild. Yeah,
no, they're domesticated.
They were cute though.
They were scary looking. Oh, yeah. They were really cute. Were they
like Game of Thrones, where they all got those wolves in the beginning?
Dire wolves.
They look like that for sure.
I like them.
We could go if you want to, but it's like an hour or two drive.
I'm down. I love. Yeah, we should go. I love.
It is on the way to Vegas, so.
That is
true. I'd rather go to Vegas.
Or to Deep Creek.
Yes, we're supposed to go. Are we going? Okay, we're going with you guys. We don't give a fuck.
Yes.
We're going to Deep Creek. Let's go.
We're going.
Let's go.
I'll meet you guys.
Okay, cool.
Okay, I'm there.
Over there.
I don't know what that is, but I'm there.
We'll go in September when it's like not too hot. Not the end of September, please.
It's been 101 degrees over there.
That's it? It's 108 with us.
Exactly. What do you mean that's it? That's still a lot.
I know, but where we live, it's hotter is what I'm saying. So I'm like,
Death Valley was like 125 the other day.
What?
Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Then I need to escape the heat and go to Vegas because it's cooler.
That's still a lot.
It is a lot.
I'm trying to be like 60.
60? That's freezing.
Is it freezing?
Yeah.
Because sometimes when Bart comes in here, he sets the AC in here to 68, and that's pretty fucking cold at 68.
Did we leave it on all night, by the way?
We did.
It's really nice in here.
Yep. Nice. That was a good idea, right?
Very nice.
Very good. I like that. But yeah, this is Liv Taylor. That's what she goes by.
Okay.
Is that the daughter or the mom?
That's a teenage daughter.
She looked moldy too.
She looked
moldy.
Joe! I'm just kidding.
There's
a selfie.
Is she in England?
And that's the mom. Yeah, they're British. How'd you know?
The girls out there have a certain look.
What's the look? That's here.
Okay!
From
that's
this picture
true.
Or
if you
from,
watch Love Island.
Yeah. From this picture or this picture?
It's a lot of inbreeding over there.
Yep. Well, no, the way.
How did you know?
Their style.
Yeah.
The way that they do their makeup.
And the hair. Yep. They always have their hair so long. Yeah.
So observant.
What's the American style then? Like, how does the American style compare to?
There's like their version of Jersey Shore, and we have our version of Jersey Shore, right? That's their version. That's all I could say. Thank you very much. Welcome to my TED Talk. Huh?
I didn't know we were.
You signed an NDA, and that's all you can say?
I don't know, man. I just observe with the eyes, and I just make observations. Observations.
Yeah, that's the mom.
I base everything I know of English people off of Love Island.
I feel like that's what Steve's mom looks like.
It's close. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Very close.
Like, I saw her and I'm like, oh, I feel like that's Steve's mom.
She's hotter than my mom.
Well, she's just younger.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Your mom was a smoke show when she was younger.
Oh, yeah, smoke show.
A smoke show,
I haven't heard that term in a long time.
She's a smoke show, really?
Oh, yeah. My mom was hot as fuck, had a great ass and everything.
Can you bring some of your mom's younger pictures?
Yeah,
it's like a bottle. I want to see.
His dad was hot too.
Oh yeah, can you send some of your dad too? Like, look nothing like him. Please send them.
My dad's still pretty hot.
Does he have a mustache? Please tell me he has a mustache.
He doesn't.
Oh, okay, I could deal with it.
He kind of looks just like Steve.
Wait, you just said he didn't.
But when he was younger, he didn't.
Oh.
He had like, had brown, like long wavy hair, and he had a mustache. He had a mustache.
He did have a mustache.
He looked like a 70s porn star.
He looked like Barry Gibb from the Bee Gees.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's pretty sick.
That looks nothing like Steve. I don't know how in his old age he looks like Steve now.
We can move on.
No, let's not move on. How come you don't introduce us to your parents?
Yeah.
There's this one time we were at a screening of your movie.
I met his parents that day.
You met the parents?
You did?
I didn't meet the parents.
I couldn't remember your name.
Oh, man.
Did I?
Well, I introduced myself too, though.
I introduced all of you guys to him.
I
said, hey, these are my buddies from JK I was telling you about.
I didn't go because I didn't consider Steve my friend yet.
Oh. Wait, what movie was
this
that?
This was 2018.
Funny story.
Like I said what I said.
Like, your parents are talking to you for a long time, and I was like,
you were there?
Oh, there's Steve's parents. Oh. And then they just kind of left. And I was like, oh.
All I remember was the lesbian girl that kept asking if you used real lesbians in the show.
Funny.
Right.
That was funny. She was great. She was
Did
really
you
fun.
Use lesbians to play the lesbians?
We're like, yeah, there's lesbians in this movie. And then she's like, are all of them lesbians? And we're
oh,
like,
oh, Jesus.
I don't know. We don't know everyone's. We didn't.
You can't even ask that.
That's a loaded question.
Yeah, we don't discriminate.
So if you guys don't know.
But did you use lesbians to write the lesbian part?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so Steve and his partner Mike Gallagher, they wrote a movie and made a movie about a woman that's in a lesbian relationship. And then at the Q&A, like, I guess a lesbian reporter or just a person in the crowd just kept hounding Steve.
And she just made it all about being lesbian. And it's like, the movie wasn't only that. There was so many other things.
Yeah.
Like Nikki making out with somebody. And Steve actually
making out with someone.
That was a week after we got married.
Yep.
Yeah.
What's that like?
I was making out
with that's the kind of questions I wanted to hear.
What's that like?
It's pretty hot, dude. Cuck shit's fun. Cuck shit's way fun.
Well, he loved the guy I was making out with.
Yeah, he's dope. He's a dope dude.
He's awesome.
Gotcha.
I said he could take it as far as he wanted to. And he respected a really interesting line.
So what happened with this girl?
Oh, yeah. So the mom posted the photo of the furry. And
why would you kick out your own daughter for something like that?
Because they're fucking us as teenagers. We're fucking trash.
True, and the daughter's 19, so technically she is.
That's the ultimate trash.
You can fucking survive on your own if you need to.
She's
so fuck
adult.
Off. Get out of my house.
I would want my kids to leave from 1 to 17,
1 to 17,
and they can come back at 18, and then they gotta leave about 24. And then they could come back at 35.
What is that gap of, what was it, 18 to 24?
1 to 18? I don't want to listen to their bullshit.
No, but you want the, like, 4 to 8.
You know what? I take
4 to 8
back.
Is, like, nice.
1 to 3 is really fucking cute, but I don't want to take care of that shit.
Too much crying.
No, I want potty trained already, so, like, 4.
Okay.
And they have conversations, they have personality, it's
I like
fun.
That. I like
okay,
that.
But they still love you, and they want to cuddle and stuff. Then, it, like, 8 to 10, they kind of start
stinking.
They start being like, you're dumb, you know, and they don't want to cuddle anymore.
Yeah, we can't even beat them up. So like from that age,
you ship them off.
Let them do something.
You can't beat them up if you just turn the lights off and you go, what happened? I don't know.
No wonder they're scared of the dark, man.
That's so funny.
The lights are turning off again. And they're like, what happened to y'all? No.
I thought you should pretend like it happened to you too.
Oh, yeah.
You too? Oh. Fuck.
You gotta be careful around here.